has got any family across the world who wants to watch any of the action tonight, this is being streamed, and you can get that on. If you go to the Facebook page for Cyclone, you will find a link on there which is from Fight Night Live TV. And if you send that link on to any of your friends or family around the world, they can watch the action here live tonight from the Civic Hall. Even if you've got family in Australia, America, anywhere, they can watch all of tonight's action from the link on Facebook, on the Cyclone Facebook. Good evening, gentlemen, and welcome here to the Civic Hall in Blackshot's Grays for Cyclone Fight Night 3. Tonight we have 17 bouts of action, 8 of which are title bouts. And all tonight's action is sanctioned by the ISKA. Firstly, Lisa and Bill Shelton would like to thank you all for being here this evening for Cyclone Fight Night Round 3. Also, a big round of applause and thank you to the main event sponsors of the evening, who without them these events wouldn't be possible. So gentlemen, please give a big round of applause to the Underfloor Heating Store from Basildon, the Budget Tire Maintenance Limited, Brentwood, the RRC Direct Tilbury, and the Advanced Building Services of London. So we thank you to all our sponsors tonight. And likewise, without the gyms in attendance with their fighters. Lisa and Bill would like to thank you for your support to Leicester Combat Academy from Barnsley, LDG Gym in Romford, the Paul Whiffin Academy in Kent, the Pegasus Gym in Aylesbury, the Assassins Gym from Crowborough, Rav Boys from Luton, Lux Martial Arts Chadwell, Five Elements Gym Basildon, the TKMA Boston, G-Force Gym London, the Winsters Gym Kidderminster, AK's Gym London, the ESKF London, the BBMA Kent, Kicks Martial Arts Brighton, and of course their own gym hosted tonight, the SXF Gym from Tilbury. This is 3 1.5 minute rounds of kickboxing. Please welcome once again, boxing out of the blue corner, representing the G-Force Gym, Addis Murasavas. And his opponent across the ring, boxing out of the red corner, representing the BBMA Gym, Anthony.
Our first bout, 1.5 minute rounds, full contact kickboxing. That means above the waist, they're wearing the long trousers. Addis in the blue, Anthony in the red. Front kick from Anthony to lead. Addis on his toes, looking to counter with the left and right, but Anthony pushing forward consistently, looking to work in close. This time it's Addis coming forward, nice spin kick, but again the aggression coming from Anthony Bailey at the moment, trying to push Addis Murasavas onto the back foot. And again he comes forward left and right, but nice turn by Addis, and a nice left roundhouse on the end of that combination. But Anthony Bailey set out his stall early to get in close and to work hard and fast. Now, 1.5 minutes rounds, they are classed as sprints in this sport. 3 rounds, winning the first is so vital with just 1.5 minutes. Nice movement again from Adis Marsalis. Anthony Bailey looking to force the issue consistently and push the pace. And as he goes so again with the right front kick, right hand follow up. Nice technical response from Adis though. Good opening round to a very good opening bout so far. Nice left hand there. And he moves sweetly out of range afterwards, Adis, and a good front kick in defensive mode. It's a good defensive weapon. Long. So round 2 of 3, very good technical opening round. As I said, Anthony Bailey looking to set the pace, but it didn't take Adis Marsalis out of his rhythm or stop him responding in kind, so it made it a very even round. And again, Adis happy to stand and trade with Anthony, who comes forward, and they've turned up the heat here in the second, and you can hear the crowd respond to this. As I said, Bailey constantly looking to push forward with those left and rights and the front kick on the end. But Marsalis has got nice lateral movement to skip away from trouble as Bailey comes in. Then looks to respond to the body well himself. Some good shots to the body there from the blue corner. Bailey responds immediately. And again, likes to take centre ring. But the thing is here, Marsalis alternates between moving away and then suddenly standing his ground to try and confuse Bailey. You feel this is where Bailey wants it most. Toe to toe, firing the shots off. Nice left and right, snappy punches and good movement from Marsalis. And then suddenly backs Bailey up for the first time in this bout. Bailey takes a deep breath, comes back with the straight kick. But as you can see, good combination work from Marsalis here in the second. And it's accurate. Very little wasted energy from the young man in the blue corner. Heavy shots now coming in from Bailey. But for the first time in the bout, Marsalis happy to come forward, picking his shots well, turning nicely. And for me, after a very even opening round with an aggressive Anthony Bailey trying to set the pace, I feel in the second round, Adis Marsalis came to terms with that style and possibly got the cleaner shots in. It's Marsalis that comes forward with the front kick, looking to push Bailey back. So tactical thinking, he's changed his style to adapt as this fight's gone on and been successful doing it. And you can see parries nicely, moves nicely. Bailey needs to do like he does in the first round, come forward, get in range and throw the shot. Had good success in the first round with that. But again, you've seen Marsalis grow in confidence as this bout's gone on. Round kick just a bit low there. Nice spin from Bailey, but just out of range. And there's where he needed to step on the gas, where he had the man where he wanted him. This is what he needs when he's in that position. This is where you feel he's at his strongest. And he needs to capitalise because Marsalis is such a good mover. And he's accurate when he counters. Nice round kick from Bailey, but stung by left hand in reply. Roundhouse from Marsalis just skims the face of Bailey, lands cleanly this time, tucks up in response. Marsalis blocks the kick, comes over with the right hand, looking to keep Bailey back in his corner. Gazim wants him to keep pushing forward and keep the pressure on. As I said, it is a sprint. And this is a very close bout between these two young men.
Decision, and that decision goes in favour of the blue corner, Addis Lunas.
So back to tonight sees Kamil Ravjani, one of Rav's boys, veterans of the Cyclone series here, and all Rav's boys, very aggressive, very technical fighters, like to fight on the front foot. And we'll give anyone a tough encounter against Zach Vasey from the Winspers Gym, the famous Winspers Gym, I must say. Very good school indeed. Known nationwide, right the way through from point to light contact to full contact. Real pedigree there, so on paper this a very good bout as one of Rav's boys, Kamil, this time, as I said, very aggressive start, as you'd expect, against Zach Vasey from the Whispers Gym. Again, 1.5 minute round, it's a sprint, and Kamil will go for it consistently. That's the way Rav's boys go for it. They put you under pressure right from the start. And this is like where they like to compete. Now what Zach needs to do is create a bit of space for himself and get his actual technique going. All of Rav's boys are so fit and so aggressive, they can mug you, which means they get you to fight their way, stand in the centre of the ring and trade with them, and they'll be happy consistently and they will wear you down. What Zach needs to do is get a bit of mobility, get a bit of range, and distance. Took the left leg to the face there, and again Kamil, like all Rav's boys, firing right from the start. Zach looking to close him down, then push forward. This is better from the red corner, and you can see Kamil looking to turn him, and he'll come straight forward again. He'll like this pace, he'll like keeping it going here. Nice side kick though from Vasey, and again the left and right from Kamil as they tie up, looking to create a bit of space. Then the roundhouse to the midsection, landed cleanly, pushing Vasey back, keeping him under pressure, and it tires your opponent as well. It's obviously a big round for Kamil Ravjani there, and he didn't give Zach Vasey time to get into his rhythm, he didn't give him space, and he landed two clean roundhouses, one to the face, one to the midsection, to take that round. Because that's how Kamil comes forward, left and right, very fast. Break, and he'll come forward again, and there will be a roundhouse on the end. Nice foot movement as well from Kamil Ravjani. And here he goes again. Better from Zach Vasey, trying to fight fire with fire here. Needs to get in first if he's going to do that. Looks for the Superman punch, but again Ravjani walks through and forward. To beat Kamil in his own game, Zach has to close the distance very fast, get him first, and be the one throwing the punches first. It's the right tactic if you can do it, and he's certainly game for it, that's for certain. You can see Kamil looking to throw that right hand as Zach came forward. And again, hits on the break, just being warned by our referee. Away they go again. Nice side kick attempt there, but good movement from Kamil. Head down, Zach. The problem for him is, as he comes with the head down defensively and throwing punches, you can't see where you are. You can't see where your opponent is either. And your opponent can capitalize on that. And Kamil trying to vary the angles now. Comes rushing forward. Left hand, left leg, right on the bell. And he's taken Zach Vasey right out of his stride. So third and final round. I've got Kamil Ravjani 2 rounds up. Zach, at the very least, needs a big third round. Goes to spin, but caught on the way in. And again, Camille, you can see the aggression there. And he's going to get warned, because his opponent was actually on the floor when that last punch landed. But it's done the job. It's stopped Zach doing his work and getting his rhythm going. As you can see there again, all the Rivjani boys very good at that. Good side kick attempt, but he walks through it again. The technique's right, and it's the right time for the technique as well from Zach, but it's the way that Camille was able to walk through it that negated the technique. And again, the head of Zach, the same, ends up very low. Now, he's being warned for pushing the head down. Camille saying he naturally comes forward like that. Referee just saying to Zach, keep your head up. And again, Rivjani looks for that left round house. Pushing forward again. Pushes forward fast, and immediately as he comes forward, Zach's head automatically goes down defensively. And this has been the problem for him across this three rounds. And you can see he ducks down low to work to the body. Rivjani just slowed the pace from the first two rounds, but when he walks through the shots, you feel he's just that bit too strong for Zach to say. And again, counters that kick and lands with the last left of the round. And I've got a feeling the blue corner is going to take this. Again, a very entertaining junior bout, though.
And that decision goes in favour of the blue corner, Camille Rivjani.
First adult bout of the evening here at Cyclone 3 seeds Connor Byrne from the AK's gym taking on Ryan Osborne from Five Elements gym, the slightly taller of the two men. 3 2-minute rounds of amateur K1 action. This one matched at 82k. Big fan support for both these young men here tonight from the Civic Hall in Grays. Great atmosphere, great venue. And it's Osborne that pushed forward first with that front kick, looking to land to the face, knee to the midsection. And when Byrne ducks low, he's got to watch that those knees don't land in the face. But aggressive pushing forward from Byrne as Osborne looks to throw the knees to the midsection. He won't be allowed to throw the knees to the face in this amateur bout, but if Byrne ducks low, one could land to the face. That's the danger here. Again, the front push kick to the face, the teep attempt from Osborne. Byrne landed, clipped with that right hand. Osborne will have to be careful. Keep that left hand up. That right hand just clipped his chin. Danger signs there for the man in the red corner. And again, using that teep, well, it's when he throws his own right hand that he's got to be careful of the right hand reply. There it is, good punching there from Byrne. Oh, nice high head kick there from Osborne on the turn, and Byrne will have to take the count. He just took some heavy shots, spun beautifully the left roundhouse to the face from Osborne, and Connor Byrne has to take the count. Beautiful movement from Osborne to set up that roundhouse. Looks to work the body. Now, how much has Connor Byrne recovered from that knockdown? Osborne not rushing things, looks for the high head kick again. Oh, and then the left hand lands cleanly this time on Byrne. Byrne looking to push forward now. That left hand coming over the top. Osborne tucking up, looking to turn his man. Just got to be careful now, Osborne. He's got the big knockdown. There's the right hand. That's the danger when the left hand's low. And it's when he throws his own punches that Ryan Osborne is open. That said, he capitalised superbly on his own movement and timing to drop Conor Byrne in that first round with a beautiful roundhouse, which obviously takes it in a big way for him. And he knows it. He knows he's got to throw it. He's got to watch for those high kicks. There's the cheap attempt again from Osborne. Byrne looking to get that big right hand over the top. There you go. And the left hand lands this time. And actually, as I said, Ryan Osborne at his most vulnerable when he's actually attacking with his own punch combinations. He's very dangerous with the legs. But there is opportunity for Byrne, who's got a cut eye here. Badly cut eye. They're looking at this closely. This could be all over. It is amateur K1. No, he's allowed to continue straight away. He needs that big right hand more than ever. And there's the left leg of Osborne. Straight to the cut. That's where he's most dangerous, Osborne, with that left leg. Oh, now the left hand. Byrne sticking in there gamely, but it's an uphill struggle now with blood coming into his eyes. He's cut above both eyes now. Both eyebrows are bleeding. Tough, tough times for Conor Byrne. Ryan Osborne, that left leg doing the damage.
Okay, fight fans, my name's Del Mann. We're live and exclusive from the Grays Civic Hall in Essex. With me, I have Joe Shelton. Joe, you're defending your title tonight. Just tell everybody what belt you're defending.
I'm defending the ISK British title.
And how many rounds is that over?
That's 5 2-minute rounds of full contact kickboxing.
Good. How's your training gone for this fight? You've been really pushing it for this, haven't you?
Yeah, I've been running 7 to 8 miles every day, non-stop, and training 2 to 3 hour gym sessions, running, keeping cardio up, strength, conditioning, and just making sure I'm ready.
Dad's been really pushing you, I should think, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's been pushing me, getting me out of bed at early in the morning, 5, 6 o'clock in the morning, sending me running.
Yeah. All worth it, though. You're gonna really do some good stuff tonight, I think, aren't you?
Yeah, at the end of the day, like he says to me, if I want the results, you've got to work hard. You're never going to get to professional level if you're not going to train hard enough. So,
yeah, That's good. You do that. I know that for a fact. Anything you'd like to say out there to any of your fans that are watching? It's live from 4 o'clock. Any thank yous or anything you'd like to say to anyone? Any mentions?
I'd like to say thank you to, obviously, my dad for supporting me through like my whole life. I'd like to say thank you to my mum, who's promoting the show, for putting me on to the show, because it's like there's 20 fights on one show, and like she picked me out of, obviously, but I'm a son, and it's just waiting.
Yeah, this is the bit now, the worst bit, I always think. When I've been out there with my fighters, they're the same. It's the waiting time now. You've done all the work. You just want to get in there and do it, don't you?
Yeah, and don't know what else.
Yeah, that's cool. Anyway, I'd like to wish you all the best for tonight, and tune in at 4 o'clock, guys, and you'll be able to watch this live. Okay, fight fans, with me I have
Paul Whiffin,
and your name is, young man?
Connor George.
Okay, Colin, so how's your training gone for this fight?
Well, we stepped in about 3 weeks like beforehand, so I've been training quite hard. I think I'm quite confident for it.
Yeah. So he's fighting Joe Shelton, who's defending his title, yes?
Yeah, that's right. No, Joe's opponent slipped out and can't fight now for some reason. I don't know why. And I said to Lisa, look, maybe try Connor. We've got nothing to lose. Again, Connor trains probably harder than anybody I know. He's there 7 days a week, and he's ready. He's ready to go. He's ready to go. Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, any game plans, or are you just going out there to get stuck in?
Yeah, just going out and get stuck in. Yeah. Try and win the fight.
Yeah, good. Well, I would do wish you all the best, and good luck for tonight.
Parts, building and maintenance services. As you reintroduce your boxers, please welcome once again, boxing out of the blue corner, your challenger, representing the Paul Whiffin Academy.
Right, we're here at Cyclone 3, and our first title is a title defence over 5 1.5-minute rounds. Smoking Joe Shelton from the home gym, from the SXF gym, defending his full contact British title against Connor St. George from the Paul Whiffin Academy. These are two great youngsters, and hats off to Joe winning the title and defending it so quickly. We've seen over the years controversy over champions not defending their title, and here is Joe defending it straight away on Cyclone 3 against a very tough competitor indeed in Connor George from the Paul Whiffin Academy. Two great camps here. Joe will have the advantage, but both these young men have got a huge future in the sport. I've seen both of these fight. Joe will fight anyone anywhere. Sometimes at the drop of a hat, I've seen Joe take something at short notice. Connor is very, very exciting. And on his day, a real handful for anyone. As I said, the great thing about these Cyclone events is you're seeing the future of kickboxing, a great showcase for young talent. And two of the best in the ring at the moment, 5-round defence of his title by Shelton. And as I said, George starts fast, he's a real handful. And I've watched this young man grow in confidence and ability. I've watched a number of Connor's fights, and he is a really tough competitor. But Joe Shelton, smoking Joe, calm, composed, knows how to use his long limbs, and not afraid to get in the trenches. And again, George looking to come forward, and it's the right thing to do. You've got to take a title from a champion. Good front push kick from Joe, and the roundhouse to the face, effortlessly done. Follows it up with a good right hand spinning kick from Connor George, but impeccable timing from Shelton in reply. What a great start to the opening round. Superb accuracy from Shelton. George comes back superbly, but just as he's at full spin, the counter from Shelton. And for me, that flurry at the end and the man that controlled it gives the round for me to the defending champion, Shelton, in a very close, entertaining opener. So round 2 of 5. Great start to this title defence. Both young men looking to start with the front push kick. Connor George looking to then close the gap Got to get beyond that front leg of Sheltner, then spins beautifully, then drops the axe. A little smile there. George grits his teeth and continues to come forward, but you can see what I say about the champion. Although he's stylish and technical, he will stand in the trenches and trade with you as well. Nice movement by Joseph. Shame he just couldn't capitalise. Paul Whiffen calling him forward. He knows you've got to take the belt from a champion. But Shelton, good turning defence into attack. He'll back off, he'll defend. And then like that, the axe kick from Connor misses and Joe punishes him for it. Connor constantly pushing forward. He's got to make the best of it as well. He's got to score when he comes forward. Take that belt away if you're going to take it. And again, the little sweep from Joe as Connor comes in. Those legs are hard to get beyond. As I said, some tall fighters don't know how to capitalise on the tools. They're long-limbed, but they don't use it. Joe does. He knows how to use the height and reach advantage. And that front leg will keep popping out whenever Connor comes pushing forward. Spins just out of range there, Connor. And the left hand of Shelton lands as Connor comes forward. And you can see Joe waiting for his man to come in, looking for that front leg again. He's got to do it just that bit faster. Ties Connor up. Much closer second round here. Very close. In fact, I'd give both young men a share of that round. Two rounds down. And I've got Joe possibly the one round up. Round three of five. And neither of these young men lacking in confidence or the ability to justify that confidence. And again, Connor looking to come in strong. This time, Joe looking for that sharp left hook counter. Left and right lands, skips away from the reply from Connor, and again his own leg jams Connor's attempted spin kick. Pace hotting up again here in the third. And I like the way Joe uses the ropes just to push back, get a little bit of spring as he comes forward, especially with that front push kick. Will back up, feel the ropes, then push forward. Nice turn there as well. Little right hand there from Connor George. Spoiling tactics here now from Joe as Connor pushes forward. Spin kick this time from Joe is just out of range, as is the axe that drops onto the back of the neck of Connor. Left hand as Connor comes forward from Joe Shelton, left and right. Right to the body from Connor, right roundhouse from Joe Shelton. And again, the roundhouse lands effortlessly to the head of Connor. He shrugs it off and pushes forward. And then Joe comes forward, took a short left hook there from Connor, right at the bell. Good work from both men, but just the cleaner for me, and it's only my personal opinion again, is for the defending champion at key moment. So 4 of 5, and Connor comes pushing forward once more, looking to work the body. Roundhouse again from Shelton. George looking to capitalize with the hands when he gets in close. Once he gets beyond those legs, he really has to work. Shelton's good at keeping the range, as you saw there, that little, but good work here, the best work of the bout so far from Connor George. Backs the champion up, gets his shots in. Better start to the round from the challenger here, pushing forward now. Pushing strongly, spins, champion just out of range. George looking strong now, confident from the early success. Shelton looks to his corner. I think he's going to be warned for holding here, the champion. Yeah, going to be warned for the neck lock. And you saw there from the champion in defence, a crescent kick. You don't see them that often anymore. Inside to outside, front push kick from Connor George this time, certainly coming strong in the fourth round, the challenger. heavy shots, the spin. The champion responds, and he needs to. And the crowd come to fever pitch now, as this title fight really hots up in the fourth. Joe Shelton, the champion, finding his second wind at the end of the round. But for me, it's the first time I've got the challenger taking a round. I've got Conor George taking that round for strong display from the challenger. Fifth and final round of an intriguing contest. George had his best round as the challenger in the fourth. And it'll be interesting if he pulls it on in the fifth, because I've got the champion one round up. The judges might not. And George is looking strong. And again, that front push kick spins. Bill urging Joe to come forward. He knows how tight this is now. As head, Conor George is a handful for anyone on this day. And he's so strong. Full of confidence after round four as well now, pushing forward. Spin from Joe, out of range there. Paul Whiffen urging Conor George to really apply the pressure. Sidekick from Joe Shelton, good defensively. Looks to tie Conor George up as he looks to get the punches going. Left and right defensively from Shelton. Front push kick. Fatigue setting in for the champ. Takes a big breath as Conor George comes forward again. The left hand probing the right. Shelton turns away. Front push kick to the face from Conor George. Lands this time. The roundhouse reply from Shelton finds its target. Nice little uppercut on the inside from the champion. Conor George, a spin kick at the end of the round. Do you give him that round on aggression? Do you give him that round on constantly going forward? If you do on my scorecard, this makes this a very tight contest indeed. Very good title fight.
After five half-court rounds here at the Civic Hall, Judge A scores the contest 49-48 to the red corner. Judge B scores the contest 47-48 in favour of the blue corner. And Judge C scores the contest 50-45. Your winner and still...
Yeah, he's good. He threw me off guard. I thought it was going to be a different fight, but you have to prepare for the worst. And it's what I prepared for in training.
Well, you've got two bad boys around you now. How's that feel?
It feels good, and it feels even better to be on my own show and get the win in front of all my family and friends.
Well, that's something else. The best atmosphere of that tonight here. And you got any...
And can I have one more word? I'd like to say thank you to my dad for supporting me through my old kickboxing career. And thank you to all.
Tibble and with his trainer Billy Shelton. Billy, tell us a little bit about what's happening tonight with this young man.
Henry's defending his Southern Area ISKA title, his first title defence, against a tough young lad from Steve Cook's gym, I believe.
Pegasus gym.
So it should be a good battle, good war.
Good. So how's your training gone, young man? Have you been working really hard in the gym?
Yeah.
Yeah. How's your running gone? Done a lot of running?
Yeah, I've been running with my dad and running at the gym.
Good. And what things do you like to do best in the gym? Pad work, sparring, or
probably just sparring and circuits.
Yeah, you love that. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, I'd like to wish you all the best for tonight, and good luck. Okay, fight fans, with me is Steve Cook from Pegasus Gym with one of his fighters that's fighting tonight for a title. What title is he fighting for, Steve?
He's fighting for Southern Area title.
Yeah, and does he know anything about the opponent he's fighting?
No, not really, but to be fair, we're not really bothered. Angelo is a tough kid. He's come over from Greece. He's had 27 fights over there. Couldn't get any more fights while he was out there. They've moved over here, and now we've challenged for a title straight away. So he's ready to go. Yeah. So we don't really care who they put in front of him, to be fair.
So how many fights have you had, young man?
What?
How many fights have you had? 22?
27.
27 fights, yeah?
Yeah.
Training hard? You've done well? Good training?
Yeah.
Yes? Yeah. Good. So it's a definite win tonight, then?
Yeah, all the way. I can't see Harry beating us, so, yeah, we'll be fine.
Do you know anything about the lad much?
No, I mean, he's tough. All the SXF lot are pretty tough anyway. And his game, I think he won it on the last show. Uh-huh. But yeah, Angelo's equally as tough, if not more, so we'll be fine.
Good. Well, I'd like to wish you all the best and welcome to England.
This is bell 6, and this will be side hall B, the ISKA Kids Kickboxing Southern.
So, our second title fight in a row, and once again, the SXF gym are putting their belt straight up after a title defence. It's great to see. You win the title, put it up to defend, no shying away, no running. And Henry De Hammer Tibble defending his Southern Area title against Agelos Kuyama from the Pegasus gym, with two professional boxers now in his corner, former world champion kickboxer Steve Cook and Nathan Graham, two top men, two top boxers, two great clubs here. And you can see the shorter of the two, Kuyama from the Pegasus gym, Henry Tibble. Last time I saw him out, non-stop action, constantly going forward. This on paper is a little belter of a bout. Tibble, real value for money. And you can see Kuyama light on his feet, come straight in to the champion, and the piston-like shots of Tibble immediately to the body of the challenger as he comes forward looking to turn him. Kuyama looking to close a slightly taller man down. And they both stand in the centre of the ring, trading away. And as I said, this is the way Tibble fights. And a beautiful left roundhouse is on the end of his combinations. He's an all-action fighter, value for money, always entertaining. Nice movement from Kuyama there. And happy to stand and trade with his taller opponent. If he does this consistently, I think it's going to be a hard 5 rounds for him, because Tibble really is a handful. That left leg, for me, is the deciding factor between the two of them. They're both very good boxing. They're both standing toe-to-toe boxing, but Tibble is getting those legs through with consistency as well. When you look at the two, Kuyama now has done two good kicks of his own, but Tibble, this is the way he likes to keep you under pressure, pushing forward. Kuyama is coping with it well, and a nice turn. And what an opening round from both these young men. And Kuyama effortlessly gets his right roundhouse to the head of Henry Tibble. And then his right roundhouse comes crashing in as well. Good opening round from these two young men. And for me, all that separates them is the extra kicks put in by Henry Tibble during that round. Apart from that, these two youngsters superbly matched. So round 2 of 5, and the only question is, can they keep this pace up? They're young, they're fit, they're fearless, but this has been a ferocious pace, and it is a pace that Tibble does like. Nice timing this time from Kuyama, and looking to capitalize when his opponent hits the ground. He is fired up to take this title from the champion. Nice left roundhouse from Tibble, and then he comes forging forward. Left and right, Kuyama looks to match him, and a perfectly timed front push kick from Tibble. Kiami, a real live wire himself, though. What an entertaining two rounds so far. And there's the right roundhouse from Tibble. Backing Kiami up. Kiami looking to turn him, looking to get his own double right in there. Body and head. Good technique from both men. Two good camps. Well schooled, these two youngsters. And Kiami happy to stand and trade with man. Good stiff left jab. Tibble looking to use that front push kick again. And then the almost front push kick turned into a roundhouse at the last second from Tibble. Two tired young men in their clinch and fall. And both young men do the roundhouse at the same time. Superman punch from Tibble. Nice turn from Kiami. He's had a good share of this second round. Nice shots through the channel. Beautiful, tight little boxing. And at least a share for me for the blue corner in this second round. Tibble didn't kick as often as he did in the first, and Kiami stayed on him. So 3 of 5. Kiami comes pushing forward with his own front push kick, and they trade punches once more. Very entertaining for Grant. And Kiami gets a little roundhouse in there himself, and now Tibble responds. Both young men looking to kick at the same time. Kiami's upped his kicking rate as the bout's gone on. Tidy little boxer as well. Tibble looking to push him forward, but nice turning, good right hand there from Kiami, and the right leg of Tibble's the response. Non-stop across these three rounds. Two talented young men here. Kiami bites on his gum shield, then throws the right roundhouse virtually from the clinch. Tibble looks for the left of the head, misses. Kiami responds. Tibble with the left roundhouse again, and then the right, and then the front push kick. Good boxing in reply from Kiami. Tibble's got his legs going again though here in the third, and that could be key. As I say that, a right roundhouse to the midsection from Kiami finds a spot. Looping right hands, two of them from Tibble, but Kiami just grits his teeth and comes back. What a fantastic little bout from these two youngsters. Big right roundhouse this time from Tibble. And Kiami still in there. Still firing away. If there's a slight difference between the two, if it's marginal, possibly the kicks of Tibble more frequent just than his opponent. But this is another close title bout with it. So 4 of 5, and immediately the big right roundhouse attempt from Kiami, looking to push Tibble back. And away they go again. And Tibble looking to get back in ascendancy, but he's not had it all his own way by any stretch of the imagination here. As I said, he likes to set a pace, he likes to be all action, but he's met a carbon copy of himself in Agalas Kiama. He's happy to stand and trade with him. Work their way out, and it's Kiama that gets the left and right in. Big roundhouse from Tibble as he comes forward, followed by the right hand. And then the left roundhouse. Right roundhouse reply from Kiama. The pace steps up. Both young men kick at the same time, giving it their all here in the fourth. Very even round indeed. Away they go once more, toe-to-toe. Tibble just steps out of the way of that roundhouse, lands with his own right hand, then a roundhouse in response. Kiama looks to back him up. And a very close round again. Hard to split them once more, because Tibble seems to have a round where he kicks a lot, then he just steps off the gas a bit with the kicking. And he could at least again, I feel, give Kiama a share of that round, if not. And here they go again. And the crowd look to get behind the hammer. and he pushes forward. Superman punch from Kiyama. And I said he's very, very good with those punch combinations. Very tidy. Nice right leg on the end there. Tibble backs him up as he likes to come forward. That left leg on the end of that combination. Kiyama stops him dead and goes again. And his own right roundhouse. And again, left jab to the body from the blue corner. Tibble pushing forward. Stiff jab from Kiyama as he comes in. Catching his man on the way in here. The kicks, as you'd expect, after four frantic rounds, not so frequent. Kiyama is the one that throws the right roundhouse, gets through again. Tibble looks for the front push kick. And slips the punch from Tibble. And looks to come back strongly again. The pace has told on these two young men. Four frantic rounds. The fifth, possibly. You can tell the fatigue. And Tibble suddenly brings three kicks in, four kicks in. And a nice little shovel uppercut there to the midsection from Kiyama. Another roundhouse from Tibble. And the roundhouse to the midsection again sinks in. And for me, this is a very close fight indeed. But if I'm going to go out on a limb and get off that fence, not get splinters in my bottom, I'll just say for me, the extra kicks from Tibble should see the champion defend his title.
At this report, we do have a unanimous decision. And that decision goes in favour of the red corner and still the ISKA Kickboxing Southern Area Champion, Henry the Hammer.
Fans, with me I have Alex Hook. Alex, you're fighting for a vacant title tonight?
Yeah, I am. I'm fighting Callum Cope from Combat Academy in Barnsley.
Mick Crossan's gym again. Very, very good gym, hey?
Yeah, he is.
Yeah. Very good gym, though, with you, with Lewis, and I bet he's, like I say, pushing you like your training partner here. He's really pushing you to the limits.
Yeah, he's been really good. I feel really strong and ready for the fight, so...
Yeah, good. So it's a K1 title you're fighting for, an amateur K1, yes?
Yeah, that's true.
That's good. Is there anyone out there you'd like to say hi to who's going to be watching who can't make it?
Nah, I think everyone's coming.
Girlfriend?
Nah, I ain't got one.
I better not say it then.
Yeah.
Okay, fight fans, well, I'll say I'd like to wish you all the best for tonight.
Round 7 and has been sponsored by Budget Tires. This is for the ISKA vacant K1 English title and will be decided over 5 1.5 minute rounds. Please welcome, boxing out of the blue corner, representing the Combat Academy, and his opponent across the ring, boxing.
So we move on to the vacant English K1 title over 5 1.5 minute rounds, which is very good camps indeed. The Combat Academy, Mick Crossland there with Callan Cope against the Assassins, Alec Hook, Lewis and Tommy in the corner there. As I said, two incredible camps. Both have transitioned from straight full contact very seamlessly into the K1 world as well. And it's been my pleasure to follow both these camps, and this is a good matchup for the vacant English title. Alex Hook light on his feet, a good mover. The Combat Academy doing very well in the K1 world at the moment. Tommy Crossland making big waves himself. I'm looking forward to Mick once he's injury free coming back into the game for one last hurrah. Always great commentating on Mick Crossland. And now we've got young Alex Hook and the Assassins gym plying their trade in the K1 and bringing their movement and footwork and ability to this arena and doing very well as well. So as I said, two top camps in this English title fight. Hook, as you can see, that superb movement that he's taken from his career into the K1 now. Nice body shots there, and the left leg on the end skips out of range of Callum's responses. Nice headshot and short knee attempt from Alex as well. Callum looking to close the gap, get hands and feet together. Nice little knee on the inside there from Alex. Well, fast-paced opening round, very close, but I'd just say just the edge with the red corner. And Alex Hook for me in that opener. Four more to go. So round two of five on this vacant English title. Hook stalking his opponent, but I said he's got such good footwork, so light on his feet, such awareness. And again, sets up the right hand, right leg, skips out of the way. Hook, a little chopping kick to the lead leg of Callum. Just a distance and timing at the moment for Callum. And again, nice work with the hands from Alex. That right leg of Callum just out of range, partly because of the awareness of Alex, chopping low kick. And Callum, bit of gamesmanship there, saying, come on, yep, let's do that, let's trade low kicks. And it's a good tactic to try and bring a mobile opponent who's having a lot of success on the outside onto the inside with you and draw him into a brawl when he's obviously getting the better of the outside exchanges. Now, good knee there from Callum, and again he's saying, come on, let's land and trade, come on, bring it on. He has success with a knee there in that combination. But Alex keeping his cool, not being drawn into the game that Callum wants to play, and picking his man off on the outside. So three of five, heating up nicely this one, very sporting contest. Cyclone series noted both for the quality of the clubs, the sportsmanship, and obviously the ability of the fighters, especially the youngsters that Cyclone showcases so well. And again, Alex, if it's not broke, you're not going to fix it, or you don't need to fix it. And again, an instant knee when they're in close from Callum, and this is why he wants it close. Confident in his ability to mix it up when they're in there short. Not so at range, I feel. Nice chopping low kicks, though. Callum, best start to the fight so far here in round three for the young man from the Combat Academy. Nice little right hand from Alex. He picks his shot so well. And then the chopping low kick, instantly replied by Callum. Now, when you saw Callum reply there when we're in close, that's why he wants it at that range. You feel that's where the fight is for him. It's just not there often enough for me. And when it's on the outside, Alex knows how to use his range. Picks his shots well. Callum doing the right thing, trying to give him nowhere to run to, so he has to stay there. But again, you saw that from Alex again. Splendid work. And there's the old adage, make him miss, make him pay, says Lewis, and he's right. And Alex is good at that left, right, though, right landed solid. You wouldn't know it, look at Callum, granite jaw there. And he's had his successes. When it's on the inside, his inside leg kicks are good. So Connor, Callum doing the right thing, trying to walk Alex down and then working close. His knees are good in close. His inside thigh kicks and midsection kids are, kicks are good inside close. You know you don't want a war with this young man. You can see that. Nice switch kicking there from Alex Hook. That's the mobility I was on about. That's the lightness of his feet. There's a grace about Alex Hook that I've always admired. He now applies a work rate and a work ethic to it as well that makes him a really good one for the future to watch out for. And as you saw there, looking to mix it, but I wouldn't, because Callum, strong, he likes it there. But good body shots and a kick on the end. Callum responds nicely, heating up here now, but it's this time it's Alex that brings the knee to the midsection and that right hand over the top. Misses with the right, and this time Callum makes him pay with the right to the body. Front push kick from Alex. Tucks up as Callum comes in, gets that movement going again. Works to the body, Callum ready for it this time. Then there, right over the top and the left to the midsection. Beautiful work from the red corner. Callum responds. Alex once again. I said the work ethic there from Callum now. And they hug. It's been very sporting. But Alex, for me, is doing enough in each of the rounds. Keeping a cool head. Keeping it at range wherever possible. Landing cleanly. Stinging right hand. Callum responds with the low kick. Alex chops away in reply. Spins, but Callum ready for it. Oh, then effortless kick from Alex. This is where Callum really needs to work now. Looks to boom in the big right hand. But it's Alex again that manages to get the knee off, showing how well he's transitioning to the K1 rules here. Beautiful shots again from the Young Assassins gym member. Jumping knee attempt from Callum. Just didn't quite find the target. Still in there, still firing away. Big right hand. Combat Academy, they're there till the final bell. Nice knee from Alex. And nicely done by Callum. Look to get that extra traction. Pushes his man to the ropes to get the big right hand. But again, both men getting the knees going. And Callum, for me, coming on strong now in this final round. He knows he has to, and he's at least sharing this one. This is where he wanted it to be the whole bout. Alex just hasn't allowed him to. And again, skips out of the way as Callum comes forward. Looks for his own right hand. Not quite as crisp as in previous rounds. I'm not surprised. Five rounds of hard, hard action. Now that, for me, Callum at least shared that round. But I still feel this vacant title is going to the Young Assassin in Alex Hook. Great back.
And that decision goes in favour of the recorder and new ISKA K1 English champion, Alex Hook. Please welcome boxing out of the blue corner, representing the Kicks Gym, Ron Tees.
Fights an excellent title. Fights already tonight. More to come here on Cyclone 3. We have 3 2-minute rounds of K1 action. Wayne Gray from the Five Elements in the red corner against Ron Tay from Kicks, with my old pal Tiffany in the corner. They're a great fighter in her own right, now becoming a very accomplished coach as well. And I was talking to her about Ron before the bout here tonight, and she said he's a real character. He loves to fight. He hasn't been training that long. He's just so determined and dedicated. And she said look out for him. We don't know what he's going to do straight away, but he is so exciting to watch. And immediately, as she said, he comes pushing forward onto Wayne Gray. And Wayne, happy to stand and trade with him. Nice high point kick from Wayne there. Ron comes through with his right and gets caught with the right in reply. So, as Tiffany and I were talking about, Ron say, prior to the fight, we're talking about you can breed technique into a fighter with heart. It's very hard to give heart to a fighter that hasn't got it. So Ron's got the first for me credentials, is the desire and the heart of a fighter. The technique will come with experience and training in the gym. It's easier to bring that in than try and give someone that might be very technically talented but hasn't got the heart for a fight. It's hard for that to translate. Ron's going to need the heart for a fight as well, because Wayne, very strong and technical in there. And a nice knee to the midsection. Ronce pushing forward. But you get the feeling that Wayne is very powerful himself from that southpaw stance, looking for that big left hand. Good opening round from both men, though. And as a raw novice, Ronce is shipping some punishment to the face there, but he's taking it well and responding. He's got to watch for that big left hand from the southpaw stance of Wayne. No, Wayne planted his feet to throw the shot, but Ron stood there, took it. Tiffany's right about him. He likes to fight. So two of three, both men have given and taken shots, and no complaints. Nice start again to the second round, and Wayne really looking to test Ron now with that big left hand, left leg, and the knee coming over the top. But Ronce pushing straight back at him, throwing a cluster of punches, then the knee, very close still. Both these men happy to stand and trade, happy to stay in the pocket, as we call it. And Ron having to suck it up there as the left hand of Wayne Gray got through once more. But he pushes forward again. K1 is about the aggression. When everything else is equal, you look for the aggressive fighter. And Ron is certainly pushing forward at every chance he gets. That said, Wayne Gray is happy to stand there and trade with him and match him. But a good right hand, left round has combination from Ronce. And aggressively here in this second round, although he saw his head snap back from that left, he stays in the pocket and throws more. Again, sheer willpower is keeping Wayne on the back foot. But that said, the left hand from Wayne Gray. Ron took that so well, then landed his own left in reply. That was a sweeter left hand, as you'll see, from Wayne Gray. And Ronce threw straight back at him. And he's keeping Wayne backed up against the ropes. Sheer willpower and aggression. You won't see a sweeter left hook than that from Wayne Gray. But you hardly knew it landed the way Ronce took it. And again, just came flying back. Wayne Gray has thrown some great shots himself, not complained, stood and traded. But Ronce is constantly trying to push his man backwards. And Wayne Gray has thrown some superb shots, just like that one. And yet the man's still there, still firing back, still coming forward. And Wayne Gray sucks it up and throws the left hand again, only for Ronce to come swarming forward once more, as he does here. He shipped at least three huge lefts, but stayed in the pocket, pushing away like that, racking up the points, using the aggression of K1. And suddenly Wayne has to bite on his gum shield and think, what do I do here? This man is all over me like a rash. And that's a powerful left hand he's had to take from Wayne. Wayne feeling the pace and the heat now as Ronce pushes forward. Tiffany was right. This man loves to fight. This is an absolute war now. And Wayne, you saw a bit on the gum shield through the big left hand, only to find that Ronce is still there, still pushing forward. Checks the kick, comes forward again. Bites on his own gum shield finally, and there's the big left hand he's got to watch out for. Snaps it forward this time, Wayne. You hear that, Wayne? You hear the crowd respond, but Ronce's still there, and here he comes again. Slips the left hand this time, and pushing forward once more. What a debut from this young man! And again, clips Wayne, called forward by Tiffany. What a great little bout this one's been. Two very dedicated, determined men. The immovable object meeting the unstoppable force. And do you know what? I've got a feeling the blue corner, with the aggression and the K1 style, will have taken what has been a hugely entertaining bout.
On amateur K1 action, we do have a majority decision. And that decision goes in favour of the red corner,
Fight fans. Here with me I have Billy Shelton. Billy, this young lady here, is she defending or fighting for a vacant title?
She's defending her British title. This will be her first title defence.
First title defence. How do you feel about this tonight then?
Feel really good. Ready?
Yeah, I've filmed you several times. You really get stuck in there, don't you?
Yep.
So how's your training gone for this?
I've been training really hard for this fight.
Yeah. Any predictions? Knockout? Points?
Knockout.
Oh, that sounds good, doesn't it? So, anything about your opponent? Do you know anything about your opponent?
Nope.
No? Obviously, have you looked into it, Billy? And just
yeah, she's from a very good camp, at Crossland. Very good girl, very technical. But we're quietly confident we'll walk away with a victory. Yeah.
Anyone you'd like to say hello or thank you to who's going to be watching from home? I know you've got a lot of friends going to be here and family, but anyone at home that's going to be watching this tonight that you want to say hello?
See you in November, Phoebe.
I'll see you in November, Phoebe. Oh, now what is that one? What is that? Is it a friend?
No.
Another fighter?
Yeah, I'm fighting Phoebe on the 27th of November for an ICO British title.
Oh, wow, there you go. So, well, I'd like to wish you good luck for tonight.
Thank you.
And good luck in your fight when you fight Phoebe, okay? Yeah.
This is the ISKA British Girls title defence and will be decided over 5 1.5 minute rounds of action. Please welcome once again boxing out of the blue corner. Representing the Combat Academy, your challenger, Rosie.
So another big title defence, this, the British title of the 5 1.5 minute rounds. And I've got to say it, the SXF gym do not give their champions easy fights. They do not give them an easy way out. Not only do they defend their title so quickly, they get real contenders. Hats off to them, because Rosie Longley from the Combat Academy will be the biggest test of Lightning Lily Copperthwaite so far. And that's what I've liked about Cyclone 3. There's been no easy defences for hometown fighters. Every single matchup has been a credible title defence. And again, defending your titles quickly, not sitting on the belt, not having it on the mantelpiece at home, but getting out there and defending it again. And this one is a tough defence for Lightning Lily. Again, an all-action fighter, Lily Copperthwaite. Saw her win a title and was very impressed with her. But the Combat Academy breed tough fighters as well. Superb gym. Led from the front by Mick Crossland. And when you see the Combat Academy, you know you've got to be at your best because they will bring it. And Lily, as I said, is always a pleasure to watch. An all-action fighter. Value for money, I like to call them. And she will ask questions of Rosie. And Rosie will have to stand and trade with the champion. Talking to the chief judge here today, and I agree with him, you have to take a belt from a champion. When it's a close fight, you've really got to show you want that belt. And Lily Copperthwaite, this is the way she likes to fight, all action coming forward. That's why she brings a crowd. And she's trying to take the sting straight away out of the challenger, Rosie Longley. And away they go once more, and a good head kick from Lily Copperthwaite. Rosie responds, but the champ has really set out a stall early here. And you've got to say, the opening round for the aggression and pace goes to the champion. Round two of five. And the champ in no mood to share pleasantries. Live wire champion. Brings a big crowd because this is the way she likes to fight. And Rosie Longley's got to match her. Got to take the sting out and start asserting her own authority. Or Lily, Lightning Lily Copperthwaite, will continue to come forward like this for the five rounds. She's the shorter girl. You want to keep her on the outside, keep her at range. Because as you can see, she likes to throw leather on the inside. Rosie's starting to work her way into this round, though. But Lily will continue to push forward, continue to ask questions. And that's where she's at her most effective, on the inside, throwing lots of combinations. Rosie, you can see good footwork, good technique. Got to keep her at range. Got to slow her up, then got to back her up, then start pushing forward. It's a process. You take the sting out of the attacks, which isn't happening at the moment, the high roundhouse from Lily. Then you stand your ground, and then you slowly start to assert your authority. That's how you turn it around. And that's what Rosie's got to start doing here. Lily will take this as a breathing space now. And she's ready to go straight away again. So I felt Rosie did better in that second round. Started to see some technique from her. Started to see what she's capable of. And again, Lily, her timing is good tonight. Waits for Rosie to commit and then throws her punches on the inside like she is doing now. When she gets inside, she really knows how to work. Rosie's got to keep her at range because this is Lily's style. This is why she brings a crowd. This is why they're so excited to watch her compete. And again, the right roundhouse, right leg. She likes to be inside. Rosie unable to keep her at range at the moment. Right roundhouse from Lily. Then the right hand on the end of that combination. Good front push kick from Rosie. This is where she needs to be at range. And you see Lily backs off to push forward again. There she goes, and she knows how to work when she gets in. Some people when they get on the inside where they need to be and they work hard to be, don't work. You can't say that of Lily. She knows she's against a taller opponent. She knows she needs to get inside. And once she gets there, she works. As she's doing now, turns Rosie again and throwing the punches, forcing Rosie to hold. The pace is telling on the young challenger. Frustration beginning to set in. Three big rounds for the champion. What can Mick Crosland do in Rosie's corner to motivate his young lady, who's showing the first signs of fatigue now? Four of five, and Rosie back on her toes, but Lily straight back to the game plan, looking to push forward with that front kick, then get the piston-like arms going, as you saw there with the combination to the body. Those arms get going, and then she keeps them going piston-like. Superb stamina and aggression from the young lady in the red corner, the defending champion. And again, works the body superbly as Rosie looks to tie her up. Pushes in again. Timing's been good tonight for Lily. She's known when to step back, and she's certainly known when to press forward. High point kick blocked this time by Rosie. Rosie pushing forward, but again a snappy jab from Lily. Timing excellent. Now walks her girl down, and when she gets close, those arms will start pumping again. And Lily straight on the attack once more. Pushing forward, the right and left going. Looking to force her girl back. And then the high point roundhouse on the end. Nice way to end the combination. Keep yourself clearly in the judge's eyes. So fifth and final round, and Rosie Longley needs a stoppage here. Lily Copperthwaite done everything right tonight against a taller opponent, kept it close and tight, frustrating, thwarting, throwing short combinations with the roundhouse on the end, front push kick, and pushing forward again. Such stamina, such determination. And that's why she's such a crowd pleaser as well. And again, working the body once more, forcing Rosie to back up or hold, not being able to utilize or capitalize on her own strengths, because it's been fought at the pace and range that Lily has wanted it to be fought at. Superb from this young lady, and a very good title defense. And as I said, when you see the Combat Academy in the opposite corner, you know you've got a real challenge. But Lily has risen to it superbly as the defending champion. And as I said, her timing, her precision, her shot choice, everything has led to Rosie Longley looking dispirited and frustrated there. And Mick in a corner as well. I think he knows that this is an opportunity that we'll have to wait for another time, because Lily Copperthwaite has defended her title in emphatic fashion here, the young lady in the blue corner. Superb defence of her title and a superb performance from Lightning.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five half rounds of ISKA action, we do have a unanimous decision. And that decision goes in favour of the red corner and
Thank you.
Okay, Fight Fans, with me again is Steve Cook with his brother Brandon Cook. What title are you fighting for tonight?
The ISKA vacant English title.
Uh-huh. So do you know anything about the guy you're fighting?
Yeah, I know he's quite tough, but I've prepared for it, so...
Yeah, you're always prepared. You've got your brother here in the corner. It's a great gym. I've been down there. I've watched you all train. I bet you've been really pushing him, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, well, he started training alongside me now rather than under me, which is great. So he's training alongside me and my other training partner who are getting ready for professional boxing fights. So we've had to take his training up a level now because there's no good putting him in a class anymore. He's too good for that.
Yeah.
So yeah, he's been training hard. He's been doing everything I do. Obviously, I won world title on your show doing that sort of training. And now I'm going professional boxing. So it's perfect for him, that sort of training.
Yeah. Exciting times for you now then.
Yeah. Can't wait now, I'm buzzing for it. Yeah,
good. Let's just go back to your boxing career now. We're all up for the one that was happening. I think it was September there.
It was in August, beginning of August. But I've got my next one is next Friday, 2nd of September, so at York Hall, Bethnal Green.
Yeah, okay, Fight Fans, York Hall, Bethnal Green, Friday.
Friday the 2nd, doors open at 6 and starts 7:30, I think. So.
So I'm going to try and get down there as well, so... Come on, Sarabi, let's get behind him as well. World kickboxing champion there going in to professional boxing. I wish you all the best, Steve, in your career, and all the best for tonight. Okay, Fight Fans, with me I have...
Muhyiddin Abu Bakr.
And his trainer is...
Sifu Ahmed.
Good. Can you tell me a little bit about who you're fighting tonight?
I'm fighting Brandon Cook. He trains out of Pegasus with his brother. I think his brother's a world champion pro.
Yeah.
I've seen a bit of his videos. It's all right.
Yeah. You're very confident about tonight?
Yeah, very confident.
Yeah, training's going really well. How's his training gone in the gym?
It went good. We saw a few videos, got a few game plans, so hopefully it should be game. Should be
better. We better keep these game plans quiet then, haven't we?
For sure.
Yeah, definitely. Well, also, I'd like to wish you all the best, but have you anything you'd like to say to anyone who's going to be watching it live out there, your friends, family who can't come tonight?
I know, I put the stream out to quite a few people, so if anyone's watching now, thanks for tuning in. Don't miss it. It's gonna be good.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be good. I'm really, really looking forward to this one, Fight Fans. I know that you're a very, very good fighter, very talented, and I know that the guy you're fighting is as well. So I think bringing the two together makes a very, very good fight. I'd like to wish you all the best for tonight.
From the ASKF fight, these two young men. Such big futures ahead of them and already going for English titles. No lack of confidence between them. And as I said, when I saw this fight card, this was the bout that I was really looking forward to. Both these young men mature beyond their years. And I think this could be one of the fights of the night, if not the fight of the night. As I said on paper, this was the one I was looking forward to. Confidence and the ability to back that confidence up for the vacant English title. What a card tonight on Cyclone 3. And as I said, having followed up Brandon Cook's career from when he was a youngster, watching him develop into the young man he is now, and he's got the movement, he's got the timing, and he can stand in the trenches and fight. And then you look at Muhyiddin Abu Bakr, so relaxed, so calm, and again, supremely talented at the age. I just hope this lives up to my expectation. First of five, and immediately Abu Bakr's spin kick to get in close. And as I said, Brandon Cook's good defensively, all happy to stand and trade with you in the trenches. And again, another spin from the blue corner. And Cook, mobile, on his toes, he'll need to be. Explosive ability, both these young men. Just misses with the right hand, Cook. As Abu Bakr spins, he's got to be careful with those spins. Utilise them sensibly. Don't get to the stage where your opponent's expecting a spin all the time. It negates the ability. There, he changed his mind and shipped a little left hand. I must admit, when you've got that ability and the ability to spin and kick like that, I always say to my fighters, save it to the third or fourth of a five-round fight. when he's not expecting it, when he doesn't think you can do it, and then all of a sudden the spin seems to come from nowhere. You've always had the ability, you've always had the capability, you just haven't shown your opponent what Abubakar's done. Is he's shown the opponent that ability right from the start, and now Brandon Cook's waiting for him to be off balance after he's thrown the kick to capitalise with his own punches. Good body shots, and Cook responds. Abubakar looking to walk through his opponent. Won't find that easy with Brandon Cook. That's why I like this matchup on paper. This is a firecracker. And Cook spins as well this time, but doesn't land cleanly. And they've had a good look at each other in this opening round. Not a lot landed cleanly. As I said, Abubakar, you saw his kicking ability, but again, for all the spins and turns, they didn't really land. And then, so, 2-5, they've had a real good look at each other. Abubakar looking to walk Cook down. Cook looking to spin from what was originally the southpaw stance into that kick, and then drawing his man on, just misses with the right roundhouse, and both men just out of range with clean shots at the moment. And slip there, Cook looking to capitalise. Clive Tennant, our referee, giving the opportunity to work their way out of it. And again, timing and range just out from both of them at the moment. And as yet, here in the second round, nothing super clean landed. And again, the spin from Abubakar, out of range, pushing forward, good left hands, landed stiffly on Cook. Cook looks to respond. That kick was blocked, and that one just missed. The pace heats up. The crowd responds. Lots of endeavour. Good right and left hand from Cook. Looks to exploit that. Looks to capitalise. And again, moves out the way to come back. Ships a left hand. Both young men just beginning to find their range now. Here in the second. Good round kick by the Cook. Nice turn from Cook. Both lads land. Cleaner work now. Timing's getting better as well. Again, not much between them. Very difficult here. Both had their moments. It got cleaner as the round went on, but I'm finding it hard to separate these two at the moment. Will the pace step up once more? Here they go. Abubakar looking to push forward once again. And I've seen Cook do this before, fight on the back foot before, pushing forward just like he did there, landed with a double left. He'll back off, he'll circle away, then he'll suddenly explode forward to look to double the power and catch you off guard. And he's doing the same again, and then he'll look to stop with the left hand. Abubakar looking to push forward though and land cleanly himself, and it's not quite happening for either man yet. Nice left right roundhouse combination. Shame that Cook slipped just after delivery. Nice left hand from Abubakar, got through the channel there this time. Cook made him miss, then you've got to make a man pay. Happy to fight with his back to his own corner. It's a dangerous game to play. And again, Abubakar wants to come forward and push the pace. Front push kick by Cook, looked to throw the right hand, thought against it. And you saw that Abubakar wanted to spin with the kick there. But as you get tired and you know you miss, you could be open to a counter. Both men thought better of it. Cook got it through with a couple of punches there. Away they go once more. Neither man again getting through that really clean shot that can be a game changer here. So styles are very similar and they tend to negate each other out a little bit. It can do that when you're a similar style fighter and you're against someone exactly the same. It can make it a hard night's work for you, and that's what's happening for both these young men here. Neither has found a clean way through yet after three rounds of this five-round title. Abubakar looking to walk Cook down and land the bombs in the corner. Cook looking to move away and then catch him on the way back in. Short right hand from Cook. Cook turns again nicely, but he must capitalize when he does that. Spin kick from Abubakar. Caught on the arms, and again neither young man really getting through cleanly, and this clash of styles hasn't worked. On paper I was really looking forward to this one. It's been a tough, frustrating night's work for both young men here, and a very tough one I feel for the judges to decide between these two, because you haven't seen that defining moment where you think, what a shot, this man's really getting through now. They both had opportunities but they've never really capitalized, and again that spin kick missed. And then Cook misses with the response and sportingly holds his man in the ring. Left hand just clipped Abubakar. Any closer, a bit more timing, a bit more distance closer, and that would have been a heavy shot. But as it was, just like the rest of the rounds here tonight, it hasn't quite paid off. And again, both boxing inside, having marginal success before they split once more. Side kick from Cook finds the target but with no real power, and again the spin from Abubakar, no chance of landing this time. One more round for them to try and get a decision cleanly. Very similar stylists, and it's worked against them here tonight. You can't argue with a stoppage, and I feel if one of these two men can do it, it would stop the arguments later, because obviously one of them, unless it's a draw, will have to lose. And it's been a frustrating four rounds. Nice right hand from Cook as he suddenly exploded forward, looking to push up the pace now. Then the round kick to the face. Way they go once more. Despite the frustration, very sporting, both young men. And both will watch this back and look at the opportunities for a clean shot that didn't quite land, that was just out of the way. They both had them. And there's still time for that one defining moment that takes the belt emphatically. Jumping front kick from Abubakar, and Cook looking to capitalize on the miss, but again nothing clean coming through from either man. Good round kick from Abubakar, right hand from Cook in response, and they're forced to break once more. Front push kick from Cook just out of range. Abubakar's left had a similar problem. Sidekick Cook misses. They tie up once more. Story of the night so far. Round kick from Cook. Replied by Abubakar. The way they go once more. Well, it's gone the full distance, gone the five rounds. I've got to be honest, not the Brad I was expecting. That's not the fighter's fault. Styles make fights and these clash, and they clashed for all the wrong reasons, which makes it very tough for the judges. And I think both these young men have had their opportunities. Be interesting to see which way the judges go, but not the fight I expected, and probably as equally frustrating for the two young men who are very, very talented indeed in that ring. Title fight. We go to 3 1/2 minute rounds of boxing. Frank Smith from AK's gym in the blue. Alfie Copperthwaite from the SXF gym in the red. Big support for this young man. So 3 1/2 minute rounds of boxing. After all the excitement of that 5-round vacant kickboxing title fight, just the punches will settle this one. And it's Smith pushing forward in the red helmet, looking to back Copperthwaite up. Copperthwaite looking to stand his ground. Smith looking to throw the left and right close. Just off balance there, it was more body to body than a punch that pushed Copperthwaite back. Smith definitely the aggressor in the early part of this opening round. And again, Smith looks to land that right hand that Alfie just out of range. Short right hand from Alfie as they break. Looking to work behind the jab now, the red corner slips nicely as Frank Smith looks to put pressure under him again. Short right hand from Smith does land. The second right's tucked up and a three-punch burst from Copperthwaite as Smith comes forward once more. Nice right hand from Copperthwaite as he stays in the pocket with Frank Smith. Nice right hand again. The exclamation mark of that exchange from the two young men. Left hand of Smith was good, but tight guard with the right hand from Copperthwaite. Not much between them. For me, just the cleaner work, as in just getting through on a couple of occasions for me, was Alfie Copperthwaite taking just that first round. So, round two of three. And Alfie not wanting to touch gloves here, wanting to get straight down to business. Looking to come forward. Smith responds. Good left hand from Smith. Looks for the left and right. Copperthwaite looking to respond. Smith warned about holding there. Copperthwaite looking to block and throw the right hand counter. As Smith comes forward. And again, Copperthwaite just missing with the right. Smith ducking low. Clive, our referee, warning him there not to duck so low underneath the hook. Copperthwaite working the body as they stay in close, looking to work himself free. Nice movement of the head from Copperthwaite just to avoid those punches. But what I like to see is once he avoids them, just to snap back in, make them miss, make them pay. Not I've got any bias here. I'm just saying on the commentary here that once you make someone miss with good head movement like that, you snap back and throw a reply. Easy said than done when I'm sat here not in the ring taking those punches. But it's half the battle. And every coach will tell you, make them miss, then make them pay. By the same token, if I were Frank Smith, I'd feint coming forward to lure Alfie Copperthwaite on, because Copperthwaite is used to Frank Smith pouring forward and then responding. You feint coming forward and then see what you can bring there. But as you saw there, he comes forward, he commits fully each time, giving Copperthwaite the chance to respond. That said, neither young man has got through particularly cleanly here in the second. So third and final round. Let's see if one of these boys can land up really cleanly and turn this one on its head. It's been pretty close so far. Neither lad getting through with a telling shot. A couple of good right hands from Copperthwaite through the channel. And again, Smith can be warned for ducking low. Told to keep his head up. And away they go once more. And again, Copperthwaite moves his head nicely out the way. And lands just with the left hand on the end of that combination. Looking to push the man back, working the body. Smith looking to hold, but the left hand through the channel from Copperthwaite as Smith tried to hold. On the right, Copperthwaite coming on strongly here in the third. And again, the right hand clean. Best shot of the night of this bout so far from Alfie Copperthwaite. Set up the right with the left and it went right through the channel. Smith took it well, but he had to take it. And again, just out of range with that looping right hand. Copperthwaite looks for the straight right again. It's been his best weapon tonight here in this boxing. Again, three punch flurry to get through as you feel that Frank Smith beginning to feel the pace. Told to keep his head up once more. And right at the bell, it's Copperthwaite pushing forward again. And I think the red corner will take this decision as well.
And that decision goes in favour of the red corner. Boxing and the blue corner, representing Kicks Martial Arts, Joseph Horwath. And his opponent across the ring, boxing out of the red corner, representing the LDG gym, Sato Ali.
So we're ready for round one. Horwath versus Ali. And Horwath shoots forward. Ali ready for him. Looks for the high head kick. Went to hold the leg there. Thought better of it. And Horwath storming forward. And Ali chips a short right hand there before he throws a right roundhouse back. He's got to watch for that Horwath right hand. And neither man wasting any time here. The adrenaline buzzing as they throw the heavy shot straight away, and both men have shipped punishment. Good right roundhouse though from Horwath to the midsection of Ali, but no settling in process, no feeling out process, just planted feet right from the start, and both men have been hit hard. You get the feeling if it stays this way it won't go the three rounds. Good left and right kicks from Ali there, and Horwath the left hand to Ali's face. I had a feeling that at that pace, the amount of punches thrown, that someone was going to get caught. And it's Ali, and Mick Foles looking very close to him. He's saying he's okay, but he shipped a heavy left hand. He's saying I'm okay, gutsy, but he still looks on heavy feet. And Horwath will come looking to land another big shot here while he's still unsteady. And there they go. Two left hands again. Ali ducks, but I think one more clean shot and this one could be all over. I had a feeling it had come. When both men stand throwing heavy shots constantly like that, something's got to give. And it's Sado Ali feeling the heat there now. And it's that left hand of Horwath that's doing the damage. Shaky leg still, Ali. He nods. He's a warrior, but he's taken some heavy shots here. And he clocks Horwath this time with the right hand. He's still in there, still throwing shots. And both men are still wide open. So a big opening round for Horwath with the knockdown. But Ali is still there. And both men are open to shots. I think a lot more drama to come in round two. And I'll still be surprised if it gets to round three. So Horwath comes flying across the ring. Ali matches him with a right and left roundhouse. And exactly the same start in round two as round one. And you know either man can get tagged. And that's the right hand this time of Ali. Horwath has to take a backward step. How well has he recovered? More of a slip there from Horwath. Ali recovered well and they're ready to go once more. Every shot is an attempted knockout, and the right hand of Horwath lands this time. They're looping punches from both men. Horwath pushing forward once more. Ali got a second wind here. Exchange of kicks, and both men feeling the pace and getting tired now. But again, the looping right hand of Allworth crashes over the top. And this time, Ali responds with the left leg, right and left punches. Crowd respond to both these men. The right hand of Haworth lands again. It's an arm punch though now, swinging arm punches. Tiredness set in from these two novices here. It's a hard, hard sport when you're learning your trade. And you're learning it in the spotlight. And no one in there to help you. Spinning back fist, Ali shakes his head. Comes back, he's recovered well from that initial knockdown. Haworth digs deep but takes a left and right and around us, and suddenly he's the one backed up, and it's Ali pushing forward. But again, even when you're in attack mode, you're wide open. That's the great thing about this bout, and somehow both these men survive to the third round. So third and final round, and both men showing incredible determination to still be there here at the start of the third, after taking some heavy, heavy shots, both of them. And here they go again, swinging every shot, looking for a finish. And it's Haworth pushing forward, but he felt that round kick from Ali. And then the left and right gets through, and a big right again from Ali. Haworth bites on his gum shield. He's taken some heavy shots in reply. Ali has recovered well from that opening knockdown. And Haworth pouring forward once more. Round kick from Ali in response. Both men really fatigued now. They've taken some heavy shots. And you feel one really clean shot on the button could finally finish this. It's not happening with man yet, but then the right hand, a flash knockdown of Ali. And away they go again. They'll be happy to see the final bell. They're feeling the pace here. Ali bites on his gum shield. An uppercut there from Haworth. Round kick misses. Fatigue, as you can see now, set in for both men. But they've given everything. They say leave it all in the ring so there's no regrets. That's exactly what these two men will be doing, leaving everything they've got in the ring, looking still for that big, big finish. And the left hand of Haworth lands again. Ali looks to turn him, throwing on instinct now. Grimace at each other and then come forward once more. Left and right roundhouses from Ali. Haworth turns full circle. Well, they managed it. Three rounds, they're both still there, and all credit to them. Gutsy display.
We have a draw, ladies and gentlemen. Please get up for both your warriors inside the ring.
Instructions before 5 1.5 minute rounds. You'll know what to expect, Luke Brooks, because he fought Kamel's brother last time out, and the Ravjani brothers came out on top. Then will Kamel be able to repeat what happened. Luke Brooks, though, as I said, very good movement. Kamel Rivjani will look to keep him backed up and under pressure. We saw Kamel Rivjani fight earlier in the evening. And they share a style, this all-action style. But as I said, I was impressed with Brooks last time out. And his movement's good. And he's got a good arsenal in that roundhouse. Excellent work. Was backed up last time, if I remember rightly. But this time looking to stand his ground and throw his shots. And is the better for it in this opening round. Kamel forced back to the ropes. Little drop of the shoulder there as well in defence from Luke Brooks. Good to see. And you can hear them calling to Kamel Rivjani. Forward, forward. That's how they like to fight. Put the pressure on. Get the combinations going. But Brooks doing a good job at the moment of moving away, then shooting suddenly back. So he moves out of the way. You chase him. Then he comes back in on you and picks up the points. Better from Kamel, but I would say a good opening round for me, for Brooks in the blue corner. So round two of five, and Kamel Rivjani looks to meet Luke Brooks right in the middle of the ring. He'll be told to come forward, put the pressure on, keep going. And you can see there's new intent about him here. Pushing forward, looking to throw the shots. Better start to the second round from the young man in the red corner. But Brooks still on fire, still matching his man. He had a very good opening round. And although Kamel has started the second better, Brooks is still there matching him. Not willing to give ground, learning from the first bout against one of Rav's boys. Nice turn there from Brooks as well. I said steps away, then pushes forward again. Not making it easy for Kamel to come pouring forward. And again, good movement and good turning from Brooks. Looks to his corner. Comes pushing forward, trying to lure Kamel on. As you can see, the little feints with the shoulders, the little movement, bringing his opponent on before he comes storming back himself. It's worked for him in the first, it's working for him here in the second, as you saw then. Nice turn, caught Kamel on the turn. Can't afford to be a static target for one of Rav's boys. And again, for me, a good second round. I thought Kamel did better in that round. Worked harder, but for me, Luke Brooks still doing the right things, and two rounds up. So round three, and a similar pattern to the opening two rounds. This is where Kamel wants to be. Forcing the issue, keeping his man trapped. What Luke needs to do is, as he's done earlier, exactly that. Turn his man, keep moving. Don't stay a static target. Centre the ring wherever possible and pick your shots. That's what he did well in the first two rounds. Kamel's got to do as he did at the beginning of this round. Get his young man backed up and start working hard every opportunity he gets there. That's the game plans for the two men. It's very simple. Luke to stay mobile, centre the ring, turning his man, never a static target. Kamel to walk his man down, work hard, keep him there, keep him under pressure. At the moment, it's the blue corner tactics. Luke Brooks from the Locks gym, they're in ascendancy. He's the young man that's asserting his will and his game plan. And again, he moves away just to lure Kamel on, then pushes forward once more. And as long as he's not a static target, he'll keep taking these points. As you saw there, Kamel out of range, didn't know where his opponent was when he threw the punch because of the mobility of Luke Brooks. And again, a good stiff left hand from Brooks, doing all the right things at the moment here in the third round as well. Nice roundhouse, big third round for me for the blue corner. Three down, two to go. And for me, on my unofficial scorecard, Kumail Rafjani needs a stoppage or at least a knockdown for a 10-8 round, because Brooks is in control at the moment. And both young men sticking to their game plans. I've been impressed with Brooks tonight. Mobile, accurate. And again, the right hand of Kumail Rafjani just out of range. That's where he wants to be. Good right hands. This is where he likes to stand and trade. But Brooks, happy to stay there and throw his own leather. Spins, catches the midsection of Kumail, forces him to bite hard on his gum shield. He felt that. Good work again from the blue corner. And again, the upward cut from Kumail just out of range. Brooks has kept up a very good pace here across the first three rounds. Slowing slightly in the fourth, but that's to be expected. It's a very hard game plan to carry out, to be so mobile and elusive across five full rounds. But he's done well. And Kumail really needs a full minute of pressure to keep his man under the cosh. And it's not really happening here. He has his moments. He has his successes. But Brooks sticking gamely to his plan, and it's reaping benefits for him. And it's Kumail who's backed up against the ropes in his own corner. And again, a little drop of the shoulders there from Brooks. He saw that. Waits to come in the roundhouse. And again, he's got one round to survive. And I feel that Luke Brooks from the Locks will be taking the British title here. And Kumail needs a big round. He needs a stoppage, because Luke Brooks' game plan has worked really well. But having said that, a nice right hand from Kumail to start the round straight away. But you feel there's enough in the tank with Luke Brooks this time to see this round out. And stands and trades with Kumail. Looks to throw the roundhouse, then moves back away. And that lateral movement being the key to his success tonight. And the timing of his responses. And again, that midsection kick lands. Kumail looking for that big right hand. He needs it. He needs an equaliser, because Brooks is not going to fade here in the fifth and final. As I said, Rav's boys, they come forward, they ask questions of you, they throw heavy leather. But you've seen the movement there of Brooks has been the difference between the two young men here tonight. In and out, lateral movement, sideways movement, catching his man, racking up the points. This is where Kumail will have wanted him for a lot more of the bout, and he hasn't had it that way. And often he's caught and then just short with his own response. Still plugging away, still trying to do what he does best. But again, Brooks pushing forward, throwing the roundhouse, throwing the right hand, turning his man, forcing Kumail to chase shadows. It's been a good performance here. And there you go for me. Blue corner will take this British title in a very good little bag.
From Rightly Crew, and your name? We've got Gary Morgan here from Rightly Crew to present the championship belt. Ladies and gentlemen, after five hardcore rounds for the ISKA British Junior title, we do have a unanimous decision. And that decision goes in favour of the blue corner and new ISKA British Junior Champion, Luke
Okay, Fire fans, with me I have Tommy West Jr. Tommy, you're fighting for a vacant title tonight. Tell everybody who you're fighting.
Gassan Gindra.
And where's he from?
Barnsley Combat Academy.
Ah, from Mick Crossland's gym. Famous gym, yeah. How's your training gone for the fight?
Yeah, it's been good.
Yeah. Lewis been pushing you?
Yeah, very hard.
Yeah, I thought he might do. I've known him for a long while, yeah. Good trainer, isn't he?
Yeah, very good.
Yeah, good. Well, so your training's been going well. Any predictions on how it's going to go?
I think it's going to be my fight, yeah.
KO or majority points or unanimous? What are you after?
We'll see about that.
Yeah, you're going to really work it, yeah. So you got how many rounds, is it?
Five rounds,
so you're going to take it easy when you start and work your way in?
No, I'm going to pressure him the whole time.
Ah, good. Good job we don't hear this then, innit? Yeah, that's good. Yeah, well, any one of your friends out there that are watching live at home, anyone, friends and family, or anyone who's helped you, other than Lewis, that you'd like to say hello to?
I think they're all coming later, that's fine.
Yeah, they're all coming later, but if there is anyone at home, he does thank you for watching him and supporting him. I wish you all the best for tonight.
Good luck. And this will decide who will be the ISKA K1 English champion. Please welcome once again, boxing out of the blue corner, representing the Combat Academy, Gassan Gindra.
So the second time tonight that the Combat Academy and the Assassin's Gym cross swords, this for the vacant English title and the K1 rules over 5 1.5 minute rounds. Gassan Gindra in the blue corner for the Combat Academy. Tommy West in the red corner for the Assassins. Lewis and Mick, their coaches there as well. As I said, two superb clubs. And matched once again for a title. It was Tommy West looked to close the gap quickly and walked on to a very sharp kick from Gassan Gindra. Said, I normally admire the real mobility of Tom West. Very elusive and hard to hit, but looking to stand and trade with Gassan in this, their 5-round title bout. Gassan looking to catch Tommy as he comes in. And they close the gap. Southpaw stance for Tommy. Superman punch, right leg, left hand. Two very talented young men in here. So you can hear them saying, don't rush it. Nice midsection kick there from West. Perfect time in spurs. Gassan into action there. Looking for the knee and the low kick. Short, sharp punches from Gassan. Kicked response from Tommy. Good timing there more than anything from West. Referee acknowledges that, no count. And again, sharp reply punches. Different start to Tom West, and do you know what? He benefited from it. Normally he takes his time coming in, works his way into a bout. Looks sharp and fast tonight. Gassan as well found his timing early. And away they go again. Exchange of low kicks. And again, just a balanced thing there. Gassan went for the big right hand as Tommy went for the low kick. Nice right hand counter, but the left hand of West is finding his range quickly. There's a new aggression to Tom West that suits him. Gassan light on his feet as well, looking to counter. Two very skilled young men in this ring. Nice low kick from West. Good front push kick from Gassan. Just misses with the left hand. Tom Gassan, a sharp response. Jamming knee there from Tom, and he needed it because Gassan pushed in. Nice exchange from both young men. Much more even this second round. Nice exchange once again. Good work here from Ghassan this time. Nice combination, ends with the left roundhouse. Nice sharp left hand on the turn as well. Catches Tom as he comes in for the Superman. And a nice right hand again for Ghassan. Accuracy here from the man in the blue corner. Now, I gave the first round to Tom West in red. Ghassan Gindra for me in the second round. So round three of five, I've got it one apiece here. The halfway mark. And again a frantic pace. Gindra gets through with the round kick to the midsection. Very similar styles, and it's working in a good way. Sometimes styles clash. And when you're very similar, it makes for a poor fight. This is making for such an entertaining fight. Because these are thinking, mobile fighters. With a great range of technique. Tommy Lord Ghassan on. Nice combination work from both young men. High head kick from the right leg from Ghassan as Tommy came in. Then Tommy looks to respond with the knee. Nice round kick on the turn from Tommy. Oh, that one right into the groin, but Ghassan made no fuss whatsoever. Beautiful spin kick to the rib cage of Ghassan this time. Perfect timing from Tommy. Nice left hand by Ghassan Gindra in response. And again, just a little clip on the leg as Ghassan set himself up. Well, very even round for me. I've got it one round apiece and one round drawn. First round for me red, second round blue, third round drawn with two to go. Round four of five. Everything to fight for on my card. And as I said, they're so evenly matched, these two, but in a good way that makes for excitement. Both looking to up the pressure, both looking to get their techniques in. Nice shot on the turn from Ghassan there with the left hand. Both lads so good at the lateral movement and their timing and their accuracy. What futures these young men have got. Gindra came in well there, left and right, both landed and the left leg on the end. Superb work so far from both of them. It's still plenty left in this one. High point kick blocked, and then Ghassan comes back with a superb left hand, jams the potential knee from Tommy, looking to take center ring now. And again the left and the right as Tommy came in. Superb timing, and the knee through the channel from Ghassan as Tommy came in. A change around in this fourth round. Low kick from Tommy, but for me, Ghassan came on strong in that round. Round four for me goes to the blue corner. I've got it two to the blue, one red and one drawn. Unofficial scorecard. Three. So fifth and final round of one of the best title fights of the night for me in terms of skill, precision, movement, accuracy. These two young men have got it all. There's the kicking ability from the full contact background of Tom. Adapting well, but takes a big right hand as he came forward from Ghassan Gindra. Looks for the low shot on the knee. Gindra pushing forward as well. They both know how important this is and warned about pulling the head down again, Tommy West. Be a shame if there's points deducted. If it's not that sort of fight, it's an instinct. And it'd be a real shame, but he has to warn him. He has pulled the head down. And away we go again. They touch gloves. Front push kick from Dindra. And the right hand and the knee jams the response. And again, jams the leg shot and replies with the left and right. Knee from Dindra comes in, the right roundhouse reply from Tommy West. Dindra is now turning superbly as well, just stepping off that centre line to make it difficult. Front push kick to the face lands from Tommy West. He gets a right hand in reply, low chopping kick.
Okay, Five Hands with me, I have Judd Button and his trainer Paul Whiffen. Paul, tell us a little bit about what Judd's fighting for tonight.
Judd's fighting for a European title, ISK European title. I believe it's 5 rounds. We train for 10 rounds. He's going to smash it tonight. He's going to smash it. Yep.
How do you feel about tonight then, Judd?
Yeah, I feel very confident. I trained hard for this fight. Got the game plan down, so it's just going to get out there and do it.
I've filmed several of your fights now. I love your hand combinations that you use. You really like putting them body shots in, don't you?
Yeah, I think they're quite effective, so...
I know they are. I'm up close and personal. I can feel them. It make me quench. I'm like, oh, I can feel that. Yeah, good.
Yeah, I know Marley's tough, so... Yeah. But I'm going to put it on him a bit, so yeah. We'll see how it goes.
I know when you fought the guy from Scotland, weren't it, here? Was it? Yeah. Yeah, and you hit him with that body shot. I slow-moed that down. And you can see that the technique, skill and the power you put into that, it was brilliant. So I think that is like a trademark I think you've got there. That's very good. I like your hand, your feet. Kicks are good, but to me I like to see your hand style is very, very good. Your movement as well. How long have you been training with you now?
Crikey, 8 years?
Six or seven, yeah.
7 years, yeah. We've had him from football. Yeah. So, he's always been able to kick.
Non-contact sport, that get more injuries than what we do. It's true, isn't it?
100%, 100%. Ankles and knees, yeah. Definitely, yeah.
So what? How old are you now?
I'm 17.
Yeah. So where do you go when you get to 18 then, when you hit the senior ranks? What's going to be on the agenda for him?
We're just going to take it by storm. We'll take it by storm. Look, we'll fight whoever's in front of us. That's what we do. That's what we do as fighters. You just take each challenge as it comes. That's what we do.
Yeah.
So he's going to do that. He's 100%. 100%.
Excellent. Well, I'd like to wish you all the best for tonight, Judd. Yeah, thank you.
Young men in there. Had the pleasure of watching both of them before. And a worthy title. Marley Mason always brings it. Judd Button, for me, love watching this man. And again, when I looked at this, one of two bouts that I thought, wow, I can't wait for these. And this is the second of them. Judd will have the height advantage most definitely, and he knows how to use it. But Marley pushes you and pushes you. And on paper, again, this could be fight of the night. I've just witnessed a superb fight between Ghassan Dindra and Tommy West for the vacant K1 English title. Two superb youngsters, and I expect this to follow it. So 5 2-minute rounds for the vacant European title. Marley leading with the jab before the right roundhouse comes in. You can see the height advantage of Judd. Marley will have to close the distance quickly and get back out. It's a hard night's work because Judd knows how to use those tools. Good left of the body for Marley. So we'll have to work in quickly, work out as quickly. And he's doing well in this opening 30 seconds, Marley Mason. Good front push kick though by Judd to the midsection. Marley looking to walk him down though. The boot needs, well, the shin pad needs readjusting. Paul Whiffen does it very quickly. And away they go again. Look at the intent on Marley Mason's face. Nice movement as well, comes in, gets the right roundhouse in, front push kick by Judd in response. And again, Marley, tight defence, comes through with the big right hand, slips the counter. Again, probing with those front kicks in the right hand. Nice big roundhouse as well, left hand. It's a good opening round so far from Marley. Right roundhouse again. Judd needs to respond. And again, Marley blocks the response from Judd. Brings that left roundhouse up again. Good front push kick. That's what Judd's capable of. Nice round kick from Judd, this time off the lead leg. Very nice technical opening round, but I'm going for me with Marley Mason in the blue corner for that opening round. Sharp technique, pushed in, timed it nicely. Some good moments from Judd Button as well. The front push kick, the left roundhouse. So here we go again. And the left roundhouse off that lead leg from Judd responded to with Marley. Better from Judd to start this second. Took one to the groin there. So I'm all right, saying he's okay, just taking the time to rest. It's difficult for the shorter fighter Marley there to keep it up, especially when you're both kicking at the same time. Judd's not one to make a fuss though. Again, the intent on Marley Mason's face, but Judd getting his legs going far quicker here in the second, just slips there. Nice work to the body from Marley as he comes forward. Judd responding with him, they've picked up the pace again here in the second. Front push kick from Judd, Marley waiting his moment, looking for the combinations. Probing to the body, comes in, right hand, left leg again. Just misses with that left hook to the face. Nice left-right this time from Judd through the channel. Looks for the uppercut as Marley comes in. Nice roundhouse. Marley doing well to the midsection here. And the right hand over the top lands cleanly. Takes a right hand back from Judd. Comes into the body once more. Nice body shot in response from Judd. Marley comes in once more to ask questions, lands with the left again. Right leg, right hand counter by Judd. Beautifully paced this second round. Superb work from both men. And both land cleanly. And again, the work to the midsection from Marley. Again, two excellent rounds here from two very good technical young men. But for me, Marley is just staying in the pocket and just edging it. I've got the first two rounds to him. I cannot... Judd pushing forward now in the third, using those long legs. Marley responds with his own front push kick. Comes in with the left hand, moves away, front push kick again from Judd. I'd like to see him follow that up as the man comes off the ropes, using his legs to advantage now, and again his shin pad just adjusted in the way they go once more. Good sportsmanship from both these young men. Better start to Judd from this third round, looking to stay in the pocket with Marley. Nice exchange. Oh, good left hand from Judd there. And the pace hots up once more here in the third. And Mason looking to back Judd up. But Button having none of it. What a third round this is shaping up to be. Good work from Judd Button here in the third. Marley looking to work him once more. Nice work on the inside from Judd Button as Marley comes in again. As I said, they've both picked up the pace, but Judd Button's really woke up here in the third. Just a low blow, Marley be given time to recover, but Judd Button's best round so far for me. Picking off the shots on the counter, pushing out that front kick, pushing it out. Good combinations with the hands. They go again. And again, that lead leg of Button's pushing out. Waits for Marley to come in. And a good right hand from Marley. Excellent third round again, but for me, across the round, I'm going with red for the first time. Three rounds down on my unofficial scorecard. I'm 2-1 to blue, but what about living up to expectation? Real. And away they go again. No let up in this bout. Supremely talented, supremely fit. Good left hand from Marley. Looking to push in. Looking to double up the left. Misses with the right roundhouse. Lands with the front push kick. Nice right hand from Mason. Button looks to respond. Round kick as well from Mason. Doubles it up. Staying in the pocket there. Forcing Button to respond. And he does. Nice left hand from Mason as he comes in. Roundhouse from Button. Good work to the body again from Marley Mason. Front push kick to the face from Judd. There's a high kick to the head of Mason. Says he takes one low. It's happening at such a pace, this fight. Go again. Front push kick from Judd as Marley comes forward. Nice roundhouse from Mason and working the body, doubles it up. Nice right hand from Mason as he comes forward. And again, the roundhouse forcing the pace, doubling up the punches. Lands with the left again, and the right over the top. Landing cleanly. Pushing forward. Nice response by Judd. What a round. And again, the sustained pressure for me came from Marley Mason in that fourth round. It was a great round, some fantastic moments from each, but Mason stayed in the pocket and stayed working, and those right hands over the top for me have taken that round. But what about four superb rounds with one more to come? It's a fifth and final round. There's been some absolutely superb bouts tonight. The bout before this was wonderful, but this is even better. This is living up to its top billing. Mason pushing forward again. And it didn't look that particularly low to me, to be honest, but Judd Button is taller. And when you're looking for the midsection against a taller opponent, it's going to happen. I don't think there's any malicious attempt from Marley Mason there. He's doing enough well without having to resort for that. I don't think there's any malice there. It's just simply that it's a taller man. We go once more, and Mason's right hand comes over the top again. Button responds. What a way to finish this bout. Just misses with the right hand of his own. Both lads going for full bore now. Superb work. What a way to finish a bout. And Mason again looking to force the issue. Caught on the way in, but he comes forward again. Nice right hand from Judd Button. This time looks to double it up. Mason relentless in his approach, keeping his man's back to the ropes. Again, two young men willing to leave it all in the ring here now. Doubles up the left hand, Mason, then the third to the body. And then the roundhouse on the end. Pushing forward once more. Nice right hand over the top from Mason, working the body. Button looking for the uppercut. Mason sticking in there again. What a way to finish this bout. Body shots, then the roundhouse from Mason. Straight back on his man. Not giving Judd Button time to breathe here. Keeping him backed in his own corner. Doubles it up again, then the right roundhouse. Good left roundhouse in reply from Button. Right across the midsection. What a pace these two men have set in the fifth and final round. Nice turn from Judd Button there. Both men really feeling the pace now. Mason pushing forward once more. Nice little uppercut on that combination. Big left hand from Button. Front push kick as well. Mason pushes forward again, comes over the top. Takes a right. What a way to finish the bout. But for me, again, for the consistency across the round, I'm going for the blue corner. I've been wrong before tonight, but I'm going for a blue win on what has, to me, been the fight of the night. An incredible bout. So this is...
Ladies and gentlemen, I can't believe the quality of the bouts tonight. It just got better and better. As we are going to do the decision, we just wait for the camera to change his battery. And then we are going to do it. So we'll just keep that tension going a little bit longer. But without doubt, he's fired him up. Tonight for me so far, it's going to take a big power to beat these two guys tonight. Warriors, please. Ladies and gentlemen, after five half-full rounds for our main event this evening, Judge A scores the contest 47-50 in favour of the blue corner. Judge B scores the contest 48-47 in favour of the red corner. And Judge C scores the contest 48-50 in favour of the blue corner. Your winner in the blue corner and new ISKA European Cadet Champion, Molly the Tarpon Mason.
Been an awesome fight, yeah? Give another round of applause to Jump Button because he is a true champion. And he will be a world champion. And I'd also like to say thank you to Mum and Dad for being there for me. And a massive round of applause to Mizzou McGash for being the best time ever.
Contact above the waist. Three 2-minute rounds of action, and this is round one. So both men having a good look before they push forward. And Laith just closing the gap, looking to work the hands after the leg. Front push kick from Laith. Lorcan, the taller of the two men, will look to keep him at bay. Nice double head kicks there. Nice turn as well. Both men tie up in the centre of the ring there. You can see the height difference as Lorcan comes forward. Those big kicks could be key for him. And for Laith, he'll need to get inside the taller man and work him when he gets the opportunity. Nice round kick and then the uppercut attempt from Lorcan. Nice round kick in reply from Laith. Away they go once more. Nice round kick once more from Lorcan. Caught Laith's attention there to the midsection. It brings the hands down over a period of time. Bit of wrestling now as they clinch up. Referee lets them separate naturally. Nice work from Laith. Alwyn there on the inside where he needs to be. Forcing the issue with Lorcan now. Looking for those heavy headshots. Lorcan will have to tidy up there. Good work from Laith Alwyn. Closing the gap, then working well on the inside. Good opening round. And you say after a good start from Lorcan Matthews, I thought Laith Alwyn came back very strongly indeed. So round two of three. Hectic first round. And again, the big legs of all back fists there. Going to be warned for that. Just exuberance, let's put it down to. Laith will be given time to recover. It did land. It's on the spin kicks. And then he spun with the back fist naturally. Close then, looking for the heavy leather game. Nice uppercut from Leith. He's definitely the better man on the inside. When he gets inside those long legs, nice chopping roundhouse to the midsection as well. There's the right hand over the top. And again, the midsection roundhouse. Lorcan will start to feel that. Nice turn as well. So Lorcan looking for the big roundhouse. Leith just catches the leg. He knows it. They both stop naturally without waiting for the referee. Good sportsmanship from both men there. And away they go once more. Leith again looking to get inside. I'd like to see Lorcan throw more big booming kicks on the way as Leith comes in, because Leith is so dangerous when he gets inside. Nice side kick from Leith there. And again, as he comes in, so accurate and hurtful. Good work again for the man in the red corner. Lorcan takes it well though. Looks good on the outside. He needs to keep it there if he's to win this, because Leith is doing the right thing, keeping it on the outside. Away they go once more. And again, you can see Lorcan looking to use the long legs, Leith looking to get inside them and work hard with the hands. So an entertaining second round, but I'm going to the red corner with that. Maximised his potential when he got on the inside and worked well on the inside there. First round was close, second round I've definitely got red. So third and final round, very entertaining. Full contact bout. Well matched, these two. Again, the big booming roundhouse from Lorcan. Needs to keep it there. That's what he needs to be doing, because you can see once he gets inside, Leith is very good on the inside. Better start to get this third and final round by Lorcan. Looking to get straight back in on his man. It's a good tactic, nice. Right leg, right hand combination. Oh, but the big uppercut from Leith, just as Lorcan was getting up ahead of steam. The uppercut rocked his head back. Took it well, though. And having to take the shots once more, you saw the head rock back again. Nice work from both men. Good bout, this one. Both taking some heavy shots still there. And again, Leith looking to work inside, get those hooks and uppercuts in. Lorcan looking to tie him up. There's fatigue setting in now. You feel they both look to their corners for inspiration. Waiting for that final bell now. Nice work on the inside from Lorcan, but Leith responds. Doubles up the left and the right roundhouse, the right over the top. Good spell here from the man in the red corner. And not the first time tonight we've seen both men prepared to leave absolutely everything in the ring to get the win. It means that much to them. Nice right hand from Lorcan there. Oh, and an equally good one in reply from Leith. Right to the end of this bout, both men going strong. And I've got to say, though, I feel it's going to go to the red corner in what was a very entertaining bout indeed.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three hard-fought rounds of full contact action, we do have a unanimous decision. And that decision goes in favour of the red corner.
Right, so once again, we have 3 2-minute rounds of full contact kickboxing. Craig Young from TKMA in the blue corner, and Matthew Gill from Locks in the red. The slightly taller of the two men, and in the completely red kickboxing trousers. So once again, 3 2-minute rounds, and Matthew Gill right out of the blocks there. A good front kick reply from Craig Young. Looks for the Superman punch over the top as Gear comes in. Throwing heavy punches. Young lands with a solid right, almost lands again, causes Gear to blink heavily there. Got to watch that right hand, and you could hear his corner say, tighten up, and they're right. Can't afford to take those big shots. Craig Young looking to walk his man down. Gear looking to keep it on the outside, but again takes another big right hand. Good front push kick from Gear. Side kick attempt from Young. Again, the right hand is the danger for Gear from Craig Young. And he lands it again. It's landing too frequently. Not to worry, Matthew Gear, this. And again, doubles up the left, then the big right again. And Gear blinking away. Nice use of the right leg, though, from the man in the red corner. Looks to come forward again. And again, Young responds with that right hand. So Young constantly pushing forward. Gear looking to use his legs as an escape route. They both tumble to the floor there. And away they go once more. And again, it's Young the aggressor looking to close the gap. Gear looking to keep him away with his kicks. So round 2 or 3. And again, Gear comes out with the front push kick. Gotta keep that left hand high as he comes forward with those kicks. And again, both men trade punches. Nice movement from Gear here in the beginning of the second. Nice front push kick to the face of Young. Better start to the second round from Gear. Getting through with his own work. And again, that right leg causing the damage. But once they're in close, the chopping punches of Craig Young cause him problems. There they go again. Gear's got to keep those legs going. They're the weapon for him. Keeping it at range. When it gets inside, Young is dangerous with those punches. As he pushes forward again. It's hard work to keep on the move constantly and constantly throwing the big kicks. But it's what will win the fight for Gear. He does not want to be in close trading punches with the man in the blue corner. Again, round head kick from Gear. Young waves forward again, sees it this time. Doubles up the hook to the body, then throws the right to the head. They tie up a bit here now, feeling the pace, both of them. And again, the round kick right hand from Gear as Young pushes forward. Takes a short right himself. And again, Young constantly looking to force the pace, but Gear getting through with a lot more shots on the turn, having a lot more success. Young looking to work the body. Better round for me, the second round for Gear in the red corner. A lot of kicks going off, got a lot of success himself. And And here we go once more. Good side kick from Craig Young to start the round. Gear looks for that pumping front kick and then the roundhouse. Throws the right hand on the end. Nice movement from Gear, but it mustn't be in straight lines. Knight, there's a good turn and a high head kick. Nice turning from Gear now. Still goes back just a little bit too far in a straight line, but when he turns, he punches on the turn or kicks on the turn and scores the points. It's good work. Front push kick from Young as he comes forward. Shields back in for Craig Young and away they go once more. And Gear looking to use that front push kick again. Then the roundhouse just misses this time and Young looks to capitalise. Psychic attempt again from Young as he comes forward. Pushing forward again, Gear. Young with a little shovel shot to the ribcage. Very tired. Competitors in there now feeling the pace of this three round. I'd be glad to hear that final bell. And Gear again, that big kick. Almost walked into the roundhouse himself there when he went to spin with his kick. Roundhouse right hand again from Gear, but this time out of range. Lands this time with the front push kick. Good response from Young. Nice exchange of punches. But again, with the range of kicking, the amount of kicking, I'm just going with the red corner on that one and the bout.
And that decision goes in favour of the red corner.
Fights, and now we have 3 2-minute rounds of K1 action to finish with Matt Shipton from the Five Elements Gym against Jordan Lee White from the Assassins Gym. And I've got to say, I always love watching Jordan Lee White compete because he gives his all every time. He's a real fighter at heart, as obviously is Matt Shipton, but I must say I've enjoyed every one of Jordan Lee White's fights that I've commentated on. He always brings it. And good stiff jab exchange from both men here. High point head kick from White. Shipton, stiff jab. White looks for a low leg kick with the right leg. Doubles up the jab, but Shipton comes back with the left and right. Very even at the moment. Two strong men in there. Steps out after his work came, but takes a solid left hand again from Shipton. Good low point kick from White. Takes the left and right hand. Response, though, from Shipton. And that big right hand again is a danger. Looks to come through the channel. Jordan responds with the left and right. Matt with the chopping low leg kick. And when Jordan explodes with those low kicks, Matt is quick to come back with the hands over the top to make it a dangerous tactic to come in. Very even opening round so far from these two men. Nice left-right combination from Jordan. Matt takes it well. Comes back with double low kick. Uppercut, though, from Jordan in the right hand. We're going to the clinch for the first time. They'll be split quickly. Both men have had their success in this first round. A little uppercut there and the shoulder of Jordan Lee White. So it looked like the shoulder of Jordan Lee White popped out and popped itself back in, and here we go once more. Round two of three. Very even match this two, and a good exchange again from them both. Happy to stand and trade in the pocket. And again, the low kick of Jordan, immediately response from Matt is the hands over the top. So he can't build up a head of steam there. He feels the low kick and responds with the left and right. High head kick there from Jordan. Matt comes back at him. Or was that a knee to the groin accidentally there from Jordan? Matt's certainly feeling it. Going to try and walk it off. Matt, it'd be a shame if it ends this way, because both these men are putting in a good performance, a very close even round. They both had some hard hits, and he's saying he's okay. Warrior spirit from both these men, and away they go once more. And again, dangerous response from Matt Shipton when Jordan Lee White goes for the low kicks. Good punch exchange as well. Good front push kick from Jordan. Matt looks to respond again. Nice left hand from the Five Elements fighter. And again, stiff left jab as Jordan comes in. Takes the high round as looks to respond with the hands once more. Pushing forward now, Matt. Jordan responds, just looks for the uppercut just out of range. Lands with the right hand over the top, though. Spinning back fist from Jordan Lee White. There's going to be a point deducted here for that. See how Matt Shipton responds to it. It did land flush. It did land flush on him, on the joy, saying it did land. Points deducted for Jordan Lee White. So it's a big point loss for him. Time back on Matt Shipton. As I said, both these men warriors. But it means that Jordan Lee White's behind on this round with that point deduction. So third and final round of our final bout here at Cyclone 3. And Jordan Lee White got a mountain to climb now with that point deduction. He'll have to go for it in this third, and knowing him, he probably will. But Matt Shipton staying composed, sticking to a game plan. Nice kicks there from Jordan. Looks for the big leg to the midsection. Matt just skips out of range, uses that left hand well. This is where he's good, coming inside the kicks and throwing those short punch combinations. Well matched, these two. Nice sporting bout, despite some of the moments. But there again, that's what I said. As soon as he sees Jordan miss with the legs, Matt is very quick with the hands over the top. And again, that left hand has been a real winner for him. Comes through the channel straight as well now. Nice bout to end the evening. Very sporting, very well matched. I think as it stands, with that accuracy of his counter punches and the point deduction, I think Matt Shipton's going to finish this evening with the win, the way it's standing. Nice knee there from Jordan, though you can never count him out. Jordan looking to punch forward with that push kick again, and immediately Shipton responds with the hands. just out of range with the low kick. That stiff left hand being a winner for Matt Shipton. Great way to finish the evening. Two very sporting warriors. I said to you.
After three hard-fought rounds of K1 action, we do have a unanimous decision, and that decision goes in favour of the blue corner, Matt Shipton. Please, now, for a great challenger here this evening, Jordan.